And we're back, getting into game number two here between Triangle Formation and Baylife. Notch, you seem to be listening to some good music and jamming out, my man. Game number one, Triangle Formation. It seems like their late game team fighting, their late game decision making was just superior. And they were able to take game number one here, man.
Yeah, they definitely capitalized on those team fights and the strength of Muriel. I'm expecting, I think we already have the bans. What are the bans for this next match
here? Muriel and Murdoch.
So, Who would have thunk?
Now, this means Steel is on the field.
This does.
So, there's...
But is this Murdoch banned, a respect ban, because Beacon's game plan on Murdoch is so strong?
I think it's yes and no. I think Murdoch is such a strong hero as a whole that it's worthy of banning. But Beacon specifically, yes. He's played several hundred games on that hero.
Yes, he has.
He's played a lot of Beacon, and we know that he plays it very, very well. So it might have been a target ban for him. Even if it wasn't a target ban, it's still an effective ban, taking that out of the equation. But leaving Steel and Rampage open opens up the possibility of that heavy initiation composition that we see frequently when you can get Steel and Rampage. It's so hard to deal with. But one of the things that makes Steel so good is if you can pair him up with a Murdoch. Steel's Shield Slam into Devastating Blast for Murdoch is a huge wombo combo that is very consistent and easy to get off. You take the Murdoch out of the equation, Steel doesn't become as potent as you would imagine. But Giant Triple Steel is, everyone knows him for his Steel and his Rampage play, and it's going to be a treat to see. I would imagine we're going to see him on Steel this game, Notch.
I would not be surprised. I'd be surprised if we don't. His Steel gameplay is some of the best I've seen. He's got a lot of, similar to Beacon, hundreds of hours.
Yes.
On that hero. or hundreds of games on that hero, and it's going to be very interesting to see how this one plays out. Of course, we can expect Decker play because Muriel is out. We're just waiting for the match to pop up here, guys, on our end, and we will jump right in.
So, what differences when we possibly see with team composition? I think we're going to see Sparrow and Twin Blast on both teams. I don't know. Let's talk about the Gideon play, because Gideon felt... Sir Sadak's Gideon play felt really good. He always landed really big black holes, but I feel like... You got the game up excellent.
It just popped up on my end.
I'm not sure what Sir Sadak could have done better to be more impactful on that hero. His late game does fall off significantly. Should they have changed their play style up instead of trying to take team fights, maybe doing some split push shenanigans? Because that's one of the big strengths of a Gideon, is his wave clear is one of the best in the game, and he's very hard. The moment that anyone tries to rotate on a Gideon, obviously he can torn space away and keep himself alive. Are we going to see a Gideon this time around? We are. We're going to see a Gideon again, but we'll talk more about that as we get into the game here, guys. So let's make sure we rewind that down to the zero. Let me update the UI real quick here. And what do you see here, Notch? We see Steel. We see Rampage. Looks like, Steel and Rampage on both sides of the field.
Yeah, double front line.
Sorry to interrupt you, my man. Let me rejoin the game because I can't see any of the items in game. So I'm going to rejoin. Okay. Rejoin real quick. Make sure that we can see items and stuff like that. It is an unfortunate bug that happens sometimes, guys, where my tab screen, I can't see kills or items or anything like that, and I really want to be... That's really important for you guys to see and for us to bring that to you. So bear with us here just a minute as we... generally, just rejoining the replay seems to fix the problem, so hopefully I don't have to do it too many times.
Yeah. We do have, again, that unfortunate bug where blue team is... on the orange side of the map, and orange team is on the blue side of the map. Cool. So it can be a little bit confusing for you guys watching. It's definitely confusing for us as we're trying to cast and figure out what the hell is going on, but we will push through like we've been doing.
Triangle Formation is in blue, correct?
Triangle Formation is in blue, yes, blue names.
Alrighty.
We do see a very similar team comp. We have a Decker on the side of... Baylife, while Triangle Formation, it looks like they do not have a support. They're running Gideon.
You're right.
Sparrow, Rampage, Steel, and Twin Blast.
All right, ladies and gentlemen, let's get into this game number two. You're ready to go do this, Notch?
I'm ready, man. I'm ready whenever you are.
3, 2, 1. Hit the P button. Take a look at the teams. Take a look at the compositions. We already kind of were teasing them before we got into the match. Something I've heard people do when I've seen triangle formation do before is run Gideon almost kind of in a support role where he picks up utility items, shockwave wards, harvester keys, things like that. I've seen that before. I've heard the terminology support Gideon thrown out before from high-level teams. How his play style differentiates from a more like mid-lane gank Gideon, I'm not entirely sure how it's going to play out, but it's going to be interesting if they're going to put him in that role. Taking a look at the items, standard stuff, man. Wards, health potions on a couple of people. This pretty much becoming standard for both of these teams to pick these early games items up like this.
Yeah, and as you can see, guys, they're running through the jungle here. They're placing wards, so they're not going to be invaded or trying to at least counter the invade. I'm a little bit, again, interested. They did so well last game, but no support on the side of triangle formation.
Yeah. So triangle formation was looking to invade here. All they did was take out the ward and actually put two wards right next to each other. I think that might have been just a miscommunication where two different people used one of the wards and placed them side by side. But hey, vision nonetheless for days on the left side of the field, yeah. Aggressively planted there for triangle formation. And it appears that Baylife is doing the exact same thing, but triangle formation seems to either know what's going on. I don't know. This is going to be invasion right here. This is going to be... we haven't seen this from these two teams. Notch Isu, he's moving forward. They're looking to go in on the blue camp. Looks like it's caught out, actually. Decker might be in some trouble. Actually, Sir Sadik is in some trouble here. And they are going to be able to get away, actually. So yeah, they thought about the invasion. I was trying to find the right person to target there. They thought about the invasion, but they're immediately going to get out and say, nope, we don't want to take this. We'll go to our blue orb and make sure we just pick up our own.
Yeah, I mean, it was smart for them to just back off and not risk the death there. If the Rampage Stone would have hit Sir Sadik, I think that we would have seen a dead Twin Blast, but unfortunately, yeah. He just tossed it a little bit too high. So they go back, they pick up their blue. We're going to see Triangle Formation rotate most likely over to their red. They're actually rotating to...
Oh, yes, they are.
Enemy red. Are we going to see a team fight here? There's a lot of vision in the jungle, So I'm sure Triangle Formation or Baylife is expecting it.
Bell walks in front. There goes that shield wall. One of the reasons why steel is so very, very strong is that steel wall. We see both of them being thrown up here. Just the double front line versus double front line. It's going to be a little bit of a stalemate as both the front lines for both these teams is so tanky, but both of them also have enough rain damage to justify staying in a team fight. Red, looks like this red camp has been taken. The Decker, Isu might be in a little bit of trouble. He's taking a lot of damage. Both are throwing a cell walk. He's getting focused down. He's taking damage too. Are they going to potentially turn this around? My little stick is going to get stunned up. He's very, very low, but the shield wall is going to separate those range damagers from triangle formation. From him, he's going to be able to get away. So again, a little bit of a stalemate here between these two teams. They're trying to find room and trying to find an opportunity to pick someone off. Selwonk's going in there through the shield walls. He's by himself. He's got to be careful. He is going to fall back knowing that he's by himself. Again, the teams, the exchanging blows of the fist right here, or bumping of the fist rather, but no one going down, and triangle formation is going to be able to secure their red camp. And as I say that, man, Baylife just wants to hang around and continue to apply pressure.
I think it's just smart for them to back off, give up the red. No reason to die needlessly here. It's the red buff that'll fall off in 2 minutes. Go start pushing some lanes. Go start some card. Go get start getting some card experience and also leveling up your hero.
Yep.
We do see the lanes are one lane is in favor of Baylife, the other's in favor of Triangle Formation. But I just start picking up card experience. You lost the buff. It's all right. Move on.
Yep. So, a fun early game. No one going down quite yet, though. I think we're going to, again, the continuation of these teams just picking up their own orb camps, the red and the blue. And then lanes will take shape from there. It is 3 minutes into the match. Harvesters are being taken by Baylife right now. Nope, it is Triangle Formation. These colors being switched up on the map. Just keep throwing both of us off, man. We'll learn. The moment we're used to dealing with this, it's going to get fixed, and we're going to be so used to the colors being reversed that it's going to throw us off again. But that's okay. That's the commentators. We got to get that on board right there, guys. Lanes are starting to take shape a little bit. Sparrow and is over here in the left lane. I'm not sure Selwonk is going to be dedicated to this lane. He's probably going to be roaming around. He's going to be jungling, trying to find opportunities for them to get some kills early on. We did see last game, Triangle Formation was the ones who got those early game kills. They were pretty much ahead up until that one botched team fight when they dove early on. With no Muriel here, Notch, I don't think we're going to see those kind of reckless dives into towers anymore. I think both these teams are going to be a little more calculated with it. Yeah,
absolutely. I don't expect the dives. I mean, as we saw, both dives cost them major team fights. I think we're just going to see more of a passive lane game. We may start seeing some major rotations to try and catch out those early kills. But as of right now, it's just we're setting up lanes. We're working on card experience. They're going to try and give themselves a slight lane advantage. We've got my little stick mid lane here. Steel, of course, is just going to push this lane back out a little bit. And we've got jungle camps taken. Their triangle formation is really focused on jungle camps right now.
Yeah, they are.
We do have, like you said, harvesters down. Left and right harvesters will spawn here in 30 seconds. So let's see if anybody makes the effort to cap those blast. And, of course, defend.
Ooh, Sir Sadic. I don't know if you guys saw the minimap, but the entire team of triangle formation was starting to converge towards that right lane where Sir Sadic was pushing out. It looks like his teammate told him, hey, man, you need to get the hell out of there, as there was a ward letting him know that they were on the way. So he's going to fall back here. Sparrow is going to continue to farm this up at her heart's desire. A Decker Sparrow lane is actually a great dual lane. It's very hard to deal with Sparrow. It basically, the stuns and the snares on Decker make Sparrow can just poke away at you and whittle you down. And Rampage actually looks like he's caught out potentially someone here. They're looking to turn around here onto Isu, but Isu's are not into Isu, but onto Thurborn. But they're going to be in a good position here. Not going to be a successful gank whatsoever. Looks like more so they're trying to take that left harvester, but it's already been taken by Triangle Formation. So he's going to be out of luck right there.
Yeah, I mean, like we said, 6 minutes in, both harvesters are up. Each team has one. Triangle Formation has the... If we're looking orange view down to the blue side, Triangle Formation has the right side, and Baylife has the left side, which, of course, the colors are reversed. Thank you, in-game UI bugs.
They're working on it. They're working on it, my man. We don't want to harp on it too much here. Taking a look at the itemization, there is a slight lead right here for Triangle Formation. And that just means they've been more efficient on the map. They've been farming the map more efficiently, really. That's really the only thing that will grant a lead at this point in time. We do see they have a little bit lead in the CS department, but I think it comes down to harvester efficiency and just making sure that they're soaking a little bit better. Beacon is up to those 12 card points. He's going to that impact hammer. This is almost the identical build we saw last match, where the impact hammer fills it up with those regular strikes. 2-point upgrade right there. You can fully upgrade that item in 2 card levels as opposed to the 3 when you're using majors. So I really like this build, and already the shockwave on Ritsukai's Gideon early on. This is definitely a big difference between the Gideon we saw last match for Baylife, where he didn't get it till his 3rd or 4th item. Ritsukai, he has a different approach. Very first item he's picking up here after his early game items is going to be that shockwave.
Yeah, and as you can see, both teams have already started taking down left and right harvesters. We do have a little bit of a harvester game going off here. True Untrue is putting a little bit of damage onto this left lane tower, but I don't think he's going to be able to take it down. We do have a rotation from my little stick. Voaz and Thurbarn are there. They're just going to back off and let that go. Same thing in the right lane. Sir Static and Isu. Isu are taking down or attacking that harvester, but Beacon is there to defend. Looks like they may just back off, though, and let this one go.
So, the harvester control, again, if it's a slow game with very little kills, very low opportunities, harvester control is kind of that secondary fallback that teams want to put a lot of focus into to make sure that they either don't get behind or are able to keep themselves up. With that being said, that means harvester controls the area around that harvester is not a place where you want to be taking team fights. So if a team might be trying to find opportunities when their opponent is rotating towards a lane harvester to pick it up, that is a opportune time to make a rotation and pick up a first blood or any kills at all. But right now, it's just back and forth control. One team controlling these side harvesters. It looks like the blue camp is being taken right now for Baylife, rather. So level 5 is on board for everyone on the side here. This blue orb might be go time for Baylife. Could be thinking about doing something here or just continue to see this status quo. 9 minutes online. We do see that Triangle Formation is going to secure that. Again, colors. It is going to be Baylife. Baylife who gets the harvester over by the Orb Prime. Very, very important. Grants you vision of that Orb Prime.
Yeah, I mean, it's a smart play, and they know how much Triangle Formation likes that Prime Orb. So giving them a little bit of sight. We do see some wards in favor of... I'm going to say it's Triangle Formation because the colors are backwards.
Yes,
so Triangle Formation does have a orb or a ward available so they can see if anybody engages that.
Yeah.
And again, guys, vision. Tons of vision for each team here. They know where the other teams are in the jungle.
So these teams continue to roam around. Decker is over in that right lane, pushing it down, actually. She's got to be careful not to overextend. Maybe a little bit of an exchange here going down in the middle or around the middle part of the map. Isu looked like he was in position, but Decker continues to push in that lane. Actually is going to get some damage into that tower. She's going to fall back, see that this Harvester's taken, be a little bit upset with it. Again, the colors. Okay, so the Harvester colors are switched up too on the in map. So
yes.
this is Baylife's Harvester. She's just getting the Harvester. Happy to push out the lane, fall back, and that's what you need to do in these kind of stalemate matches, is push the lanes, slowly siege down the towers, and that tower's gonna be, that right lane tower is gonna be down to about half HP.
Yeah, it looks like they are gonna take out the boss Harvester here. So triangle formation, trying to give themselves another Harvester. And just give themselves that advantage. Could we see them trying to take the boss? They're all five here going to be trying to take this this prime orb right now.
We see the Baylife is getting themselves in position to respond to this. My little stick, he's looking to initiate in here. They are level five. Now, are they going to continue to kill this boss? It is about half HP. Selwonk already preemptively putting him in a spot to try to ward away any sort of aggression that comes out here from Baylife. The boss is going to go down here, so this may be go time. We actually looked like they were maybe trying to be a steal there, but yeah, triangle formation takes that with very little contention, and they're going to be taking this across the field. All the meanwhile, though, Sparrow was pushing that left lane and was able to get that tower down, and this is what they need to do. They weren't able to get the orb, but we talked about this many, many times before, Notch. If you aren't able to get the orb, push down that opposite lane. That's exactly what they're going to do. So I like that they were able to push down that tower, push out that wave, and just make it that much more difficult for triangle formation to activate those prime cards.
Yeah, triangle formation now has to come over here, and they have to push the lane back out to give themselves that advantage. A very good play by Thurborn getting that pushed out. It actually looks like Chipperl is actually just running this in. Yep. Oh no, Chipperl's he's leading it, but they're just going to run it in. They're not going to worry about pushing the lane out. They should be able to get this prime orb.
And Baylife doesn't, they're not with it. They're not together. They're just going to pretty much turn this in, and this could be a disaster for them. They got to be careful, though, because Baylife is a little bit separated. Orb Prime is about to be turned in by Steel right now. Thurburn gets caught out in travel mode. Giant Ship, if he uses his ult here, they could just take him out. But Giant Ship, there comes the Chaos Dunk onto two. The Steel and the Rampage are in a lot of trouble. Ritsu uses the Shockwave. Here comes the Black Hole as well. Ritsu is doing it, but they can't focus him down. He gets a full duration Black Hole. He torn space out. He's going to get away by the skin of his teeth. Is Isu on the chase? But again, is Isu abandoning the rest of his team? I think he is. He is going to go down here. Decker's trying to do what she can, but right now, this looks like a one-for-one exchange, a Sparrow for a steal. The Twin Blast is getting beat up here. All the meanwhile, Rampage did get taken out for Baylife. Sir Sadak in some trouble. He's going to get taken out. So that looked like a 1-for-3 exchange favoring triangle formation. Again, the front line of Baylife, I felt like they overextended. They opened up triangle formation to go in there and take advantage of the fact that their backline was exposed. That's exactly what happened. They're going to get 3 kills and they're going to get this mid tower.
Easily going to get that mid tower with that Prime Orb. And if depending on Baylife coming here to defend, they could possibly get a tier 2. We're most likely going to see triangle formation just back off and go push another lane.
All right, guys, taking a look at the card power after that team fight there. So it is card level 6 here for Sparrow and Rampage, as well as Beacon's Twin Blast. Again, he went to that Impact Hammer. Two Impact Hammers back-to-back. I love this. I think this is a great build on Twin Blast. I myself build like this because, you know, obviously Beacon's following me when it comes to those builds. So we actually see two Shockwaves on the side of Triangle Formation right now, on the Steel and on the Gideon. That is so much control coming out here from them. That's just massive. Having two Shockwaves is so valuable in these team fights, and that may have been what happened to swing that team fight around. I'm not entirely sure. It was a little bit clustered inside the jungle there, but I mean, how many there is a Shockwave for Baylife, but they don't have the Gideon. They're only going to have one. Another card we haven't talked about, that Barrier of Will, is up on My Little Stick Steel, Notch.
Which is a amazing card. It gives you physical armor, max mana, but what makes this card so great is the unique active ability. It gives you a shield based on your level to nearby allies. So if anybody's in that range, you are getting the shield. And of course, the upgrade bonus, 22 physical armor, 22 energy armor to any allies in range. So it's definitely extra shielding, a little bit of protection from that damage. Absolutely wonderful card for Steel.
So it looks like Triangle Formation is just going to fall to their jungle, clear it up, and be happy with the fact that they have a little bit of momentum right here. They were able to get a tower. They're actually pushing down the tower right now. That is Baylife Picking up that tower on the right part of the map, that's good. Both of the side towers are now taken out for their team. That's something Triangle Formation actually hasn't been doing a good job of. I thought they had a little bit more map control than they have, but they're actually behind on the map control because they haven't been able to pick up a single tower. They did take that team fight, and they did turn in that Aura Prime, and it looks like they finally are going to start threatening this left lane here as they push it down. True Untrue does have that black buff on the Sparrow, so they should be able to pick up this tower utilizing both the black buff and the Orb Prime card, which actually just left, but still, this tower's gonna...
They will be able to get it.
Yeah, this tower's gonna melt. Look at Steel's positioning. Look at my little stick Steel positioning, but they know about this. There's two wards right there. Is he gonna go in? Here comes the flank, but he's gotta be careful. Immediately turns around, recognizing that he's by himself and he's gonna get caught on here. Meanwhile, there is an initiation over here. Selwont gets rooted up in his travel mode, and they're trying to punish the Steel for being out of position. They're continuing to chase him. We see the Shockwave get used. He actually has to ult defensively to get up here. That's not what you want to see, but here comes Chip with the ult. That's the one you want to see right there. Shockwave to knock him out. Shockwave number two. Holy cow, that's the strength of that card. Here's the black hole as well. It's going to keep him in place, and down goes the Decker. That was massive. The shield slam coming out there from Giant Chip was absolutely amazing to behold. The double shockwave just threw him up in the air. There's not much you can do about that. 3-0, and now the left lane is going to be under huge amounts of pressure.
Amazing, amazing play right there. He got three people in it. Double shockwaves back to back set them up to truly just annihilate that enemy team. This tier 2 tower is going to go down. They're probably going to push this down and then just back off as the rest of the team has spawned. We're only 16 minutes in. The death timers for Baylife are not huge.
Yeah.
And they are backing off.
So they are going to, they're going to take the red camp, invade the jungle. If they have any wards, I'd imagine that they're going to ward up this jungle very, very aggressively. That's more than likely what they will do if they have wards. We do see Baylife starting to converge over in this lane. Is it to potentially take control? Excuse me, apparently I'm drinking too much soda. Take control of this jungle here. Looks like they just want to push out this wave and make sure that their inhibitor is not going to be under any pressure. This left lane, man, is always going to be in the back of the heads of Baylife right now. With it being exposed like that, and with the Orb Prime boss going to be respawning here in just a couple of minutes, that left lane is going to be a very key point for both of these teams, offensively for Triangle Formation, defensively for Baylife.
Absolutely. We do see Triangle Formation here running through, cleaning up the jungle, giving themselves advantage with buffs. But we do have the Prime Orb will be spawning here, I think, in the next minute or two.
Yeah.
But Triangle Formation showing what they do best. They've got a very aggressive play style. You saw that with when they had the Prime Orb. We got three people in Giant Triple's ult. They're pushing back. They're playing very smart right now, making sure they're getting the card experience from the jungle, keeping their lane somewhat pushed out. We'll probably see them rotate over here to this right lane to get this lane pushed out and give them that advantage in the end.
Let's take a look at the card. Wow. Okay, that's just taking a look at the numbers. The numbers speak for themselves right there, Notch. We see almost 3 level card advantage, sometimes 4, coming up here for Triangle Formation right now. The Impact Hammer now going into that brand of the Iron Eater, so going into some Lifesteal as well. After that, we may see some crit or just straight energy damage for Twin Blast. The Barrier of Will is now online for Chip. He maxed it out with 1-point cards with 2 minor guards and a basic mana. I really like this because all you want in that Barrier Will, you get that Barrier Will for its unique active, the shield based on your level, but also the passive as well, something we didn't talk... I don't believe you mentioned that, Notch. It gives you that passive of 22 physical armor and 22 energy armor to everyone around you. So that passive on it is so just very, very valuable. This Steel right now from Giant Ship is just, he's landed initiations, he's taken nerds out, he's shockwaving people, he's defending his teammates with Barrier of Will. Just a phenomenal play coming out of here. Another possible engagement over here by the Orb Prime. There is a shield slam for My Little Stick. They need some follow-up on it, though. They're going to knock Beacon around. Beacon's in a lot of trouble. There's Shockwave coming out there. Beacon, is he going to go down? He's so very low that all they need to do is hit him, and down goes Beacon. So right now, this is looking like a good exchange for Baylife. The containment field is going to separate Ritsu Kai away from the rest of his team. Meanwhile, over here in the part of the jungle, Chip and Cellwonker by themselves 2v4 right now. They have to be careful. Status bomb, Boaz is in some trouble. Decker's out by herself. She's gonna rocket jump over Chip, over the shoulders, charge forward onto Decker, knocks her up. Chip's in take, getting low though. The shield walls are just trying to separate the enemy team from the rest of them. Chip's gonna get knocked up here. Isu looks like he is trying to get up here and chase down Ritsu Kai, but right now it is a 1-for-1 exchange. The Sparrow of Baylife is taken out right now. Ritsu's gonna torn space away and turning this around over in the jungle. We do see that Milo sticks in trouble. This is again again looking like an advantageous team fight for triangle formation. They take out the they took out the twin blast. They're going to take out the steel, and again a clustered team fight inside the jungle. The shield walls all over the place. Triangle formation again coming out on top.
Absolutely amazing team fight for triangle formation there. They responded properly. We see the strength of Shockwave. People were talking about Shockwave and how strong it was, and it is such a strong card. It swayed that team fight, definitely in triangle formations, being able to get those double Shockwave off. In the meantime, though, we do have lanes being pushed out. Beacon is now on cleanup duty a little bit, trying to make sure this tier 2 doesn't take any damage. But great team fight overall right there. That was an absolutely amazing team fight. Triangle formation played that really, really well.
Look at the card power. That's kind of what we were expecting. The separation continues to build and build and build. We actually see Ritsukai going into two Shadow Scrolls, maxing them out with the cast. So just getting some utility out of those with the energy penetration, but still putting focus into the energy damage aspect to it. So this Gideon play from Ritsu, not to take away from Sir Sadak's play right there, but it seems like Ritsu's playstyle on Gideon just seems to be a little bit more impactful than that of Sir Sadak, or it could just be the team fighting capabilities of triangle formation is just making them look good, you know? It could be, but right over here, again, both these teams are posturing around this Orb Prime. This could be, I mean, the past two or three team fights have favored Baylife. Generally, like a 1-2 or 2-4 exchange. There hasn't been a big one-sided team fight right here. But this Orb Prime, if Triangle Formation are able to pick this up and turn it in and not lose anyone, they could absolutely just push down that left inhibitor, slow siege that left inhibitor, and get the first inhibitor of the match.
Yeah, absolutely. They are a lot of posturing right now for this. We see a lot of vision on the map from both teams. Selwonk is in a position. Selwonk actually just caught Isu out.
Yeah.
It doesn't look like his team's there to back up that catch or close enough to back that up, but we could see a team fight right here in the jungle.
Now, Twin Blast is a little bit late to the party here from Baylife. They are converging around this jungle. The Sparrow is by herself right now in mid lane, so maybe they're trying to do some kind of split pushing. I'm not entirely sure. Looks like they're falling back, just trying to take wards out. Yeah, so both the teams are kind of being very, very patient when it comes to this Orb Prime. Triangle Formation definitely seems to have the advantage here. Go Selwonk. He's jumping in on my little stick. He caught him out. Not sure if there's any follow-up here from the rest of his team. It's not. Look at the flank coming around. Look at the flank coming around. They're coming around from the back lines. They know about it, though, because there was a ward. Ritsukai, they had a flank coming around the back line. That would have been huge. Giant Shift might be in position. Here comes the Shield Slam on a 2 in the back line. They need follow-up on this, though. There's a Shockwave. There's the Rampage coming in. True and True is about a half HP right now. There's a Boulder to the face. There's a Shockwave onto Isu, though. Here's the Black Hole. Again, Isu's by himself right now. It's a 3v1 situation. He's focusing down True and True. Might be able to pick him up, but the crowd control and the peel right now from triangle formation is so very good. All the meanwhile during the rest of this, though, again without the protection right there, the Baylife is getting walked over here. We actually see Selwonk was back there. Not gonna happen. My little stick's in trouble again, time and time again. Notch, the fighting from Baylife is very discombobulated. They seem to be making some miscommunications with each other. It was just a separated team fight. Triangle formation was able to recognize, capitalize, and now they are gonna get this Orb Prime.
They are going to get this Orb Prime. They did lose one, but I mean, that was... Isu needs to do a better job protecting his team. If you paid attention there, Selwonk is actually building some health regen, and with his passive ability in the jungle, he's regenning quite a bit. So he's able to 1v3 like we just saw. While the rest of his team was turning around, trying to deal with the Rampage and pick up those kills, Selwonk jumped in. He's regenning. He's dealing a lot of damage because he's built more of a bruiser instead of a tank, and he was just able to keep them separated. And again, team fight advantage goes to Triangle Formation. They will pick up this blue buff, this prime buff, pretty much uncontested.
Yeah.
And then, you know, of course, push down their lane and go to run it in. And the currently the map control on the left side of the map is in their favor. So they don't have to slow push here. They can just run up and hopefully get this turned in.
So guys, this is a momentous occasion for Triangle Formation. They're looking to get the first inhibitor of the match. They're looking to take game number 2. They're looking to take Agora's Rising at number 1 with that prize pool, which has been so generously contributed by the community. Thank you to each and every one of you. But Baylife, they are up against the ropes right now, and if they don't play this exactly the way they need to play it, they could be getting taken out right now. We saw before what happened with the Orb Prime. Now, Triangle Formation is not afraid to be a little bit patient here, to be a little calculated, group up, let the lane push out, and then make a concerted effort to turn in the orb and try to take a team fight. Every single time Triangle Formation's done this, they haven't really done any split pushing tactics. They've always grouped up as five, and then they slowly siege down that lane until they have an opportunity for their Rampage to jump and turn that Orb Prime in. I think that's exactly what we're going to see again this time around. With that being said, Baylife is a little spread across the map right now. We do see that both Sparrow and the Twinblaster are on the other side of the lane, but they're recalling. Yeah, they're starting to recall right now. They're recognizing the convergence of Triangle Formation in the left part of the lane, and this team fight is pretty much inevitable right now to happen over this Orb Prime notch.
Yeah, it really is. The Thurborn and they're just trying to get that tier 2 tower a little bit of protection. They are going to come back. We are going to see a full 5-man fight here. But as we've seen these fights go, Aisu needs to pay attention to his back line. He likes to jump back and try to deal with True and True and Beacon, and it's costing his team. Selwonk, of course, he's on Rampage, boys. He just jumps it in. Orb Prime has been active.
Here we go. They're going to look into it. They initiate on there, recognizing that Selwonk is not in the team fight because he's turning in. Beacon's in a lot of trouble. He needs a shield. He dodges the shield slam, actually, but Sir Sadik's in a lot of trouble. He's going to get knocked up right there, and he does get taken out. All the meanwhile over here, Black Hole getting a lot of value. Beacon's in trouble, though. Aisu wants to get him down. Aisu is the man. He's going mental right now. He does take him out. So a one-for-one exchange right here. This is what Baylife needs to do. My Little Stick is in there. True and True is low on energy, soon to be low on health, but no. Unfortunately, Rampage gets taken out. Again, Thurborn is actually by himself. Selwonk might think about chasing, but they got to pay attention here. My Little Stick's in a lot of trouble. He's going to take it out, and that is going to be yet another favorable team fight for Triangle Formation. They were a little bit more connected that time. Their timing went in to push into him when they knew that Selwonk wasn't in the fight was good. They initiated well, but again, it just seems like Triangle Formation's ability to peel for their injured teammates is so strong. That feels to me the factor in these team fights is why Triangle Formation is coming out ahead.
Yeah, the ability, I mean, you noticed Chip turn around there and save True Untrue with his charge, was able to push My Little Stick off True Untrue.
Yeah.
Just solid rotation, great communication on their part, noticing that this needs to be done. Selwonk feels comfortable because he knows how he's building his Rampage.
Yeah.
He's got the health regen, he's got an Orb Prime buff and an ultimate. He can just allow his team to do what they need to do. And again, favorable fight for Triangle Formation.
An uncharacteristic mistake. Triangle Formation seems to have a miscommunication. Selwonk went in the inhibitor completely by himself. And now Baylife, they're on the charge. Isu's by himself, but My Little Stick is here to try to turn this around relatively. He drops down, he hits True Untrue. True Untrue is very low, but there isn't any follow-up. There's the containment field on the True Untrue. They try to take her down, they do take her down. This could be a moment for them, but Sir Static's in a lot of trouble. They have to peel for Sir Static. They have to keep Selwonk off of him if they want to turn this around. Sir Static is going to pop his ultimate. He's so low. Selwonk's trying to get it. He pops the enrage. He does get him. So one for one. Over here to the left, though, we do see Thurborn and Beacon going out of 1v1. Beacon's low. Can they take him down? Shield wall's huge here. Beacon gets the shield, though, from the shield wall, and that is going to turn this team fight around. Giant Chip, what a player right there. If that shield wall wasn't there, Beacon would have gone down, and this may be a fight once again favoring Triangle Formation. It is a 2-for-2, though. This is anyone's fight. It's anyone's game at this point right now. Selwonk's low. We know he doesn't have his ultimate. He did use it earlier on there, so they could focus him down if they want to, but the only physical damage coming out from Triangle Formation is Beacon. It's just the steel on the Rampage versus the steel on Rampage plus the Decker, actually. So right now, this is a little bit of a wash between these. I feel like with the heroes currently alive for both of these teams, neither of them can kill each other. The first even exchange right there, but Baylife, they needed to get more out of that notch, though they were able to successfully defend the inhibitor.
The one thing they needed to do was defend that inhibitor, and that's what they did. Yes, they lost some heroes in the process, but at the same time, Triangle Formation lost a couple. That means there's a few people down the OP buff, which will be falling off in just a minute, actually.
Yeah.
So great defense by Baylife. They've set themselves up to not have to worry about one lane, and that's a huge issue.
Yeah.
The super minions are so strong in this game, not having to defend that lane as hard because of super minions.
Yeah.
They're able to start pushing out other lanes, and they're hopefully able to give themselves a little bit more cushion when it comes to the map advantage, which was definitely in favor of Triangle Formation.
Yeah. Pharaoh's pretty much by herself inside of the enemy jungle. She's got to be careful here. True and True, I know you're a farm Sparrow man, but you really got to be careful about that. I think they're trying to chase down My Little Stick right there, but he's going to be able to get away just fine. Taking a look at the card power after that team fight, the gap feels like it's actually been narrowed down a little bit, or it's become stagnant. I mean, we've seen these team fights haven't been hugely favorable for one or the other. They've been either been even or slightly favoring triangle formation right now. But the card difference has pretty much remained the same. That is 42 card points right now for True One True. She's already got her Blade of Agora completely maxed out. The Wind Carver Blade maxed out with some speed on there. She does have some 32% crits. So this Sparrow is going to be start just chunking people away. Not only the Sparrow, but Beacon's Twin Blast as well. He has those impact hammers. He has the Lifesteal and the Brand of the Iron Eater. Now he's building into a Blade of Agora. So his fourth item is going to be the Blade of Agora. His fifth item, more than likely, is going to be a crit item. And once Beacon gets that crit item, the damage he's going to be doing is going to be absolutely massive.
Absolutely. Now we see these teams just going back to their positioning. We're cleaning up the jungles. We're trying to get caught up in a little bit of experience for Baylife. They are, like you said, not too far behind. They're pretty close, and it's due to no major deaths and no major 5v5 wipes there. What do you think the next step is for Baylife? What do you think they need to do here to get themselves back in the game? Because they're not out. They are at a disadvantage. But what do you think they do here to try and take a lead? Do we look for an early gank? Do they go for the Prime Orb? Or do they just continue to farm up card experience?
We're approaching that stage of the game where Gideon starts to fall off here, Notch. And I really think if they're able to capitalize on the fact that Gideon's late game presence isn't as strong as a Sparrow or a Twin Blast, which both of these teams have. If they, because Ritsu Kai, though, with that being said, has been so smart about his black holes. He always goes in at the perfect moment, knowing that he can get it off. He's not going to get focused. He's not going to get turned on. But I feel like they need to be a little bit more cognizant of Gideon in these team fights. And more importantly, we talked about it before, not to harp on it too much, but they need to protect their backline a little bit, specifically Isu and My Little Stick. They seem to be separating these team fights. I feel a disconnect between them.
Just had Selwonk actually get a major stun on Thurborn. Thurborn is going to fall here, guys.
That is not...
That was not what they needed at all. Yeah. No, Thurborn got caught out. Selwonk was able to jump up on the ledge here. He actually trapped Thurborn in travel mode, and full 5-man. I mean, everybody was there. The rotation was there, and they easily got that kill.
The timing on that could not have been worse here, Nox. The Orb Prime boss up again. This is going to be a hat trick for Triangle Formation on picking up the boss here. And again, left lane is pushed out favorably for Triangle Formation. That's where they're going to go with the Orb Prime. That left lane inhibitor, the defense from Baylife has been there. They've kept that inhibitor alive, I believe, two times now. But this third time, we're coming up on half an hour in the match. The Rangers are on their fourth and fifth item. I think as long as they're able to get this Orb Prime turned in, even if they take an even exchange, they still should be able to get that inhibitor down right here. Baylife, I mean, what's the call right here? They have to put a defense here for the left lane, but at the same time, they gotta be worried about their other lanes as well. It's this team fight right here. I feel like if Triangle Formation takes a one-sided team fight, that's gonna be the end of the game. But this is an opportunity for Baylife to swing this around. That point I was trying to get off before Sparrow got caught out, Isu and Little Stick on the Rampage and Steel need to be a little bit more conjoined in these team fights. They need to be peeling a little bit better. The peeling for Triangle Formation has been superior to that of Baylife, and that's been the really big factor for me in why these team fights have been favoring Triangle Formation. Baylife has to peel a little bit better for their backline. They just have to.
Do you think we could see a split push here? No, it looks like they're all going to rotate over. I was expecting maybe they delay a little bit because you have 3 minutes after you kill the gummy bear boss to turn that in. Maybe we get a bit of a split push, but it looks like what we're going to see, all five rotate over. They are picking up this black buff. They're setting themselves up to win right here.
They are,
they
man.
They want the strength. They're going to pick up the black buff. It is going to go on Selwonk, and that's Rampage is able to tank these towers with an Orb Prime buff. He'll have no issue if they win the team fight getting this inhibitor down.
Is what it comes down to. My Little Stick already not in the best position. He might get initiated on here. Selwonk's in the front, but they're going to be all right. That could have been a very unideal situation if My Little Stick got caught out there. Not going to be the case, though. Ladies and gentlemen, this is going to be a huge team fight for both of these teams. The frontline Steel and Rampage in position. Look for Selwonk to go, and then now look for them to initiate, for Baylife to initiate. They're going to go in. They're going on to True and True. He's by himself. They have to get him down. Ritsu Kai uses the Shockwave number one. True and True's in a lot of trouble. There's a Shockwave number two. Barrage Thurbone in trouble. They focus down Thurbone. They're not able to get True and True for, though. They need to get True and True. Isu, he's focusing on there, but his backline, is it being protected right now? Selwonk is pretty much 1v3 and by himself, but there comes the Shield Slam. Isu again is by himself. We talked about this, Notch. Characteristically, unfortunately, Isu's gonna get taken out. He's separated from the rest of his team. Two are down right now for Baylife. My Little Stick, Selwonk actually did a very good job at zoning out the rest of Baylife while they zoned out Isu and took him out. And this is a 3v5 situation with a Black Buff on the Rampage, with their Prime Orbs activated, with a 5v3 power situation. This inhibitor is going to be dead. Can they go for the throat here? If they get any more kills, they could go for the throat in this series, become the first champions of Agora's Rising number one. Look at that inhibitor melt. Looks like they are going to decide to siege down this core notch, but they have to be very careful right now.
I think, you know, with teams coming up, they're just going to back off. We're going to get another lane pushed out. They're able to take down tier 2 tower in mid here. They made the right call by not pushing this. They have the advantage. They still have Black Buff. They have Orb Prime. This inhibitor will go down.
Yeah, I mean, you saw how fast it melted.
Yeah, I mean, I don't see this inhibitor surviving through this. We've got some shields keeping the range damage off, but no, we lost this as well. This is a tough fight for Baylife. If they lose anybody here, they will lose the game.
Isu's in there, again, trying to focus down True Untrue. True Untrue might be beaten, might be bruised, but he's been playing such a phenomenal Sparrow. And again, it comes down to the peeling. And oh wow, look at Thurbone getting focused right now. He's got to be careful. Beacon did get ulted on. He's getting really low. He's separated by himself. He needs some peel. He needs that characteristic peel coming out from the rest of his team. He's still alive somehow. Black hole. He rocket jumps away. He's still alive. He's turning on his tail. They just don't have the damage notch. They don't have the damage. They're going to get taken out. 4-0 right there. The power of the Prime Guard.
And Selwong is on the enemy core. It's at 50%. That is going to be GG. Congratulations to Triangle Formation for securing the win. That was incredible gameplay from Triangle Formation, man. Absolutely.